So eBay has lied to us about managed payments. Yep, they flat out lied to us several times about managed payments. And in this video, I want to talk about exactly what those lies were and why some of them really stink and they're really inconvenient, why some of them are actually a good thing for us. What's up, everyone? Paul here from dropshippingtitans.com, where I teach regular people just like you how to start your own successful eBay dropshipping store. And I've been on managed payments now for 4 full days. And I wanted to give you my initial reaction to it because there's some stuff that I really love, some stuff that I find super confusing, and some stuff that eBay has just flat out lied to us about. So if you're not familiar with managed payments, under eBay's old system, buyers used to come to eBay.com, they would find items they want to buy, and then they would go over to PayPal to actually purchase it. That was a credit card processing company, PayPal. Now eBay has gone all in one. So you find items you want to buy on eBay and you make the purchase directly on eBay.com. They process the payments themselves directly on the eBay website. Now, this is obviously a huge transition for eBay, a big move for them. So it is taking them multiple years to roll this out, which is also part of the frustration because they've had years to kind of plan this. And I don't think they've done the perfect job of executing it, and definitely not as well as they should be doing for such a big move. So for those of you who are not using managed payments yet, I wanted to give a quick breakdown of what the registration and activation process was like for me. So I received an email from eBay in early June letting me know that I had to register for managed payments, and they put a link in there for me to do that. I clicked on that link, went through the registration process. It was quick, it was painless. This part eBay got done right, or they did it right. And I just quickly blew through it in about 5 minutes, and that was it. They then told me that I would be activated by the end of July, and then I just waited. Now, at the end of July, they sent me an email, another one, telling me that I would actually be activated between August 3rd and August 7th. So then I waited a little bit longer, and on August 5th, I got an email, sorry, on August 3rd, I got an email telling me that I would be activated on August 5th. And then on August 5th, sure enough, that morning I woke up, I was already activated that morning. So it's been 4 full days for me. And I kind of want to talk about the things that I like so far about managed payments and the things that I am not crazy about. So the biggest thing that I love about managed payments is that it's just very organized and very simple to use. Instead of having to bounce between using eBay and using PayPal, I just have to click on one tab on eBay and it shows me all the information about my payments right there in my eBay account. And most of it's very simple to understand. So for instance, it tells me the last time I was paid, and then it tells me the next date that I'm going to be paid. It gives me a breakdown of my invoice that I have to pay at the end of the month right there, and it shows me all my recent transactions and how much that's going to cost me in terms of final value fees. So I can see it really easily organized in one place. But there's one thing on this payment screen that I find really pretty confusing, and that's the section that tells you about your pending funds and your available funds. So I'll tell you what I do understand about it. Where it says available funds, that's the money that's going to be paid out to you on the date of the next payout. But the pending funds are not yet available for payouts. And there's a few reasons things would fall into pending as opposed to available. So the first one is if you're a new seller, all your funds are going to go into pending until you actually show that the item has been delivered. Then eBay will put that money into available for payout and then pay it out to you on the next payout date. They do that to all new sellers for the first couple of months that you're selling. Also, any cases or returns, the amount of that transaction will also be moved into pending. So let's say 2 weeks ago, I sold an item that cost $50 and I've already shipped it out. I've already gotten paid for it. That money's in my bank account. But let's say today a customer opens up a return for that item, $50 of my available funds would move into pending and stay there, even though it wasn't for that sale because that sale happened 2 weeks ago. And it'll stay there until the return or the case is resolved. All of that makes sense to me. All of that is clear to me. But what doesn't make sense to me is that some payments that I receive go into pending and I don't know why. They don't fall into any of those categories, but they get stuck there in pending. A lot of those, most of them actually, move into the available for payout by the end of the day, and then it gets paid to me the next day. But a couple of them seem like they don't. It's not clear to me why, and I've called eBay about it, and they've just told me all the information that I just told you, and they can't really answer why some of these other payments are being put into pending. So that kind of gets me scratching my head about that one. Now, one thing I've been really happy with, and even though I know some of you will not agree with me on this, I've been pretty happy about how quickly I've been getting my money from eBay, how quickly it's been landing in my bank account. So for me, what I've noticed is that the money during the day, it gets paid out the next morning by eBay. Now, as soon as the payout happens, it doesn't land in my bank account right away. It takes some time for the bank to process that. And for me, using Capital One, I get it the next day. So for instance, all the sales I made on Wednesday, they got paid out Thursday morning, and then I received them in my Capital One bank account on Friday. So the reason I say this is because if it's taking longer for you, try switching to a different bank. Capital One's working for me in about 48 hours or less. So if you're struggling with that, then maybe try Capital One. But there is a really, really big but here, because there is one thing that eBay kind of lied to us about that puts a large caveat on what I just mentioned. All right, so eBay originally told us that we would be able to get our money every single day from eBay, that we would have daily payouts. And actually, if you go on the payments tab on eBay for the managed payments section, you'll see that there's a choice between weekly payouts and daily. And for a while, or for the first couple of days, it seemed like the daily payouts were working until we got to the weekend and they stopped working. So apparently, in eBay's mind, daily payouts does not include weekends, which wasn't obvious to me at all, wasn't obvious to anyone I spoke to, in fact. So a lot of people think that this was kind of like a slight on their part, it's kind of like a half truth. You know, it's not a huge deal, because you should be using a credit card to fulfill your orders anyway. You know that money's on your credit card, and then once the money's released to you by eBay, you just use that to pay off your credit card. It doesn't matter if there's a couple of extra days delay. So not a big deal, but I kind of wish that eBay had just been upfront and honest about it from the start. But here's where things get a little interesting, because earlier this year, eBay made an announcement about the managed payments fees that a lot of us were pretty bummed out about, but as it turned out, that announcement wasn't even true. So eBay had told us that the final value fee, once we started using managed payments, would be based on the final price of the item after sales tax. So just as an example, let's say I sell an item that costs $100. Now, my final value fee is 11.5%. So I would owe eBay $11.50. Okay, no big deal there. Pretty excited by that, because those fees are lower than they were under the old system. But let's say that customer was charged sales tax. Let's say it was $5 in sales tax. Now the total after sales tax is $105. And eBay had said that we would be charged 11.5% of $105. And we were bummed out about this, because this would actually raise our fees, cost us more money. But as of right now, that's not happening. I'm getting charged 11.5% of the $100 before sales tax. So I don't know where the misinformation came from. I'm really not complaining too much, but I am slightly apprehensive, because I know that maybe that will be changed in the future. But for right now, I'm not gonna complain. So there you go. Those are my initial reactions to eBay managed payments, all the things I loved and things I didn't love. Overall, I think it's great. I think it's very organized. It's very simple, you know, more minimal, which I really like. I do wish that they would give you more information about why certain payments are pending. They should actually just tell you why any payment is pending. Also, even though it's not important to me, I know it's important to a lot of you guys, so I do wish and hope that in the future they add the option for instant transfer to our bank accounts. That way, even if we can't transfer on the weekends, at least first thing Monday morning, that money could be transferred instantly into our bank account so we can get those funds and start using them right away. Now, managed payments is just one of many changes that have happened with eBay dropshipping over the past few months that have made this one of the best times ever to start dropshipping on eBay. So if you want to learn about what all those changes are and why I think now is one of the best times ever to start dropshipping on eBay, I'm hosting a free live webinar this Tuesday. So for all the details, click the first link underneath this video. It's completely free. Join me, learn about why now is one of the best times to start dropshipping on eBay. All right, guys, thanks so much. Hope you like the update, and I'll see you guys on Tuesday. Bye for now.